biologist, mainly in cotton, though I also work on rice. So we took a very urgent measure to address the problem of mealybugs that were attacking cotton in Hola, which is a scheme in the NIB. So what happened is I looked for the products that we would use to manage the mealybug. But before I go into the science, it's good to have a background of how cotton came into Kenya and where we are. So cotton in Kenya was introduced in 1900, now those years, so it is over 100 years since cotton was introduced in Kenya. And before that time, cotton had been introduced in America by the British, but when the Americans had a war in 1861 to 1865, the British were coming to Africa. That is when they came and started growing cotton in Africa, mainly in Kenya, Nigeria, Sudan, Rhodesia. For some of us who are a bit old, we remember in those olden days we used to read books about the cash crops in Africa. Kenya was one of the major cotton producing countries in Africa. So all through in the 1960s, 80s, cotton was a major crop in Kenya. But unfortunately, in the late 90s, cotton growing declined. That was after the liberalization of the cotton industry, when people were allowed to import or sell the cotton the way they wanted. So before that time, cotton was being managed by the cotton, the Indian Marketing Board. It is a very good order. Farmers used to farm and used to get money. After the regularization, the farmers were very much discouraged. Cotton research in Kenya is conducted by two main centers, Kari, I don't know where the right is, somebody. Katikati. So, Kari Mwea, Kari Kivos are the only two centers in Kenya mandated to conduct cotton research. Cotton, the area that is potential for Indian cotton is hectares. The country has a potential to produce 300,000 bales. The annual production was the highest in 1970s. In 1985-86, when Kenya produced the highest production of 70,000 bales per annum. That time, about that percent of the cotton in Kenya was coming from Bura and Hola. So you can imagine, the entire, when we had all this, 30% coming from Bura, Hola irrigation schemes. So out of this 70,000, Bura produced that one. So Bura and Hola have a very high potential cotton production. And let us remember that now the government is in the process of reviving the cotton industry, which collapsed in those years. So the current cotton production in Kenya is around 50,000. This is after from the year 2000, that is the time the government started revitalizing the industry, and we have seen an increase. In 2006, we were producing 23,000 bales per annum, so there's an increase. Last year, and let us remember, Bura and Hola irrigation schemes are being revived for the last few years. So last year, Bura and Hola produced only 2,000 bales. It's not too small. Having started from zero, of course they have totally stopped growing. I have a farmer here, and he knows zero bales were being produced before these years. So, 35-4 of the industry is there. And the area in which cotton can grow in Kenya is allowed 87% of the nation. This area is home for 27% of the Kenyan population. This is about quarter of the Kenyan population. So when we revive the cotton industry, it is going to touch allowed this percentage, a quarter of the nation's population. The potential mentioned, currently the average yield by the farmers is 600,000, and research findings show that you can get even 2,500 kilograms per hectare. So there's a deficit of so many kilograms. This is a trend, how cotton went. Yes, 69, that was the production around 30. The years I've mentioned, 85, around 85, we had the highest, 7,000 bales. After liberalization of the cotton industry, there was a decline. 2003, the government started revitalizing the cotton industry. So today we are here. Just go back to cotton, study cotton, study cotton clothing. So there's a lot of concern in the revitalization or reviving the cotton industry. So it is sad. Kenya, a nation that can grow cotton, 80% of the nation importing was only clothing. In fact, that was only crop mentioned during anybody. So you can see how serious it is. What caused the collapse? High cost of production. Yes. No regulatory body, the cotton intern marketing board collapsed, but cotton is back to take its place. Liberalization killed the industry. Importation of secondary hard clothing killed the industry. Low producer prices, my farmer friend knows that the low prices made the farmers not to grow cotton. Competition with other hybrid crops, like in Imwea, people are growing agricultural crops, they are not interested in cotton, although there's a cotton growing area. Lack of certified seed killed the industry. High cost of inputs, yes. And now rainfall, arthropod pests and diseases, lack of certified seed, substance chemicals, these are the adulterated chemical products. Yes? 3 minutes?
Yes.
Let me go to the science now. We'll go very fast.
Oh, the science.
Yeah, the science. Why I went to Hora and water was a blessing. Why cotton mineral is a major phase of cotton worldwide, Kenya included. The cotton mineral, which made me and Dr. Ajong go to Hora in Punjab, India. It's also a problem. It causes around 12 to 40% crop loss in Kenya. The trial which I'm going to show you, I have said that I saw that the loss was about 47%. So it is even more than in India. The loss caused by the mealybugs. Mealybugs is a major place of cotton in Coast Province, Bura and Hora included. So the science, the materials, the metals we used, RCPD, design, crop was grown under irrigated conditions. These are the products we tried. Yes. Using the experience I have for the last 30 years, I chose these products to control the mealybug. This is the mealybug I'm talking about. The design is there, the spacing we used. A farmer in Hora, yes, there, the crop, the mealybug causes that damage for irrigation in Bura and Hora, that was in Hora. After applying those treatments, this is what I found, the best product was that one. We had zero mealybugs per plant. For the control head, about 6, very high population. This shows that all the products worked, but the best one, the most cost effective was Rogo. This is dimethoid. In fact, it's a very cheap product. In fact, that was the aim. We achieved the aim we went for. So we were able. Okay, this was the situation before the application of the products. I've done it upside down. Before applying the products, this is the way the products were looking like. So before applying, the population was almost the same. After applying, that is what happened. So all the products gave significant reduction in the mealybug attack. Now the yields, what pros you gave the highest yield? Logo is dimethoid and acetab gave us the highest yield of almost 3.5 tons. Yes, I say in this area I've been able to get 2.5 tons, but at irrigation you can even get 4 tons per hectare. Yes, that is 1,500 kilos. The farmer said it's good to say per acre. The highest, this is allowed 1.5 tons per acre. So at irrigation, very high yields are realized. Now, farmers like hearing of the prices. The product which gave us the best profit was Rogo. But no, as a tough, it gave around 120,000 shillings per hectare. It is allowed around 50,000 per acre. That is the profit we realize after doing cotton in an irrigated condition. The resource, all the products applied, gives significantly raw in the bag populations compared to untreated. As a tough at that rate, according to that, the highest profit was realized after using this product of 126,560 shillings per hectare. Currently, your draws after doing that trial, but that the mealybugs can cause that loss. It's a very high loss in terms of money. The cost of acetab and Rogo are that amount respectively. Rogo is a very cheap product, also acetab is not very expensive. The other products, though they give high yields, they were more expensive. When I did the gross margin analysis, in fact here there's a slight mistake when I give the little paper, the best product which was most conspicuous is Rogo. So this is number one, this is number two. When I was doing the write-up, I got mixed up. But the deal paper has explained all this. So, in my recommendation, I have given Rogo as my recommendation. So, I would like to acknowledge the Director Kari, the Managing Director NIB, Mayor, the Rihora staff, plus the staff at Kari Mwea. In fact, I have a detailed paper, it's here, it's complete, and it's available in the proceedings. So, here is our objective, but I would like us to repeat the trial, but it was only one season trial, which gave us a very conservative product, which the farmers can use. Thank you.